and the obsession enters, you know, I need 351 pair of shoes, I need 352 pair of shoes, and it's sort of like this is a defining, you know, thing, and it's sort of idea consumption is sort of this way to, you know, fight mortality or fight death is, you know, the more real estate I own, the more clothes I own, the safer I am. And it's really a fallacy that we tell ourselves. And these pictures were, you know, these are just personal things that I have. You know, one day you wake up, and the next day you wake up and your house is blown away, your whole world has changed. So, and there's nothing we can do. There is no such thing as purchasing security. It's a fallacy. And so this is a dress by Victor Nuoff, and she's in front of a house that was destroyed. Well, when this, actually, I photographed this. I printed the pictures, I sent them to the magazine, Italian Vogue. And 3 months later, when these pictures were on the newsstand, the Hurricane Katrina hit New Orleans. And so that was, you know, the magazine was on the stands, and Katrina happened, and the magazine got all these letters because they thought the pictures were about Katrina, and the editor was mad at me. But I was like, well, you know, I took these pictures before, you know, Katrina. She's like, yes, but Kenya, it's not, something's gonna be, we're getting letters, people are not happy. You know, what was these pictures about? I said, well, it was about hurricanes. You know, it's about the world is changing, and, you know, we're obsessing over our shoes. And yeah, it's okay to wear nice shoes, it's okay to look beautiful, but, you know, just to have a little bit of balance and, you know, perspective. Is important, and not just distract ourselves with our purchases, that happiness will come with the next purchase. So that's when I realized, with this photo session, I realized I was sort of at the end of my career in fashion. I really couldn't say anything more than I had said without getting into trouble. And it was getting more difficult to get the pictures published. This is called Amanda David. I'm 55. This is a photograph. Sort of just, you know, again, playing with ideas of materialism and mortality. You know, what are we gonna do with all this stuff? You know, when you die, I keep thinking, God, something happens to me. What's going to happen to all this junk I've accumulated, you know? And I don't know, there's something really beautiful about living light. And there's also a lot of, you know, commentary about the death penalty. Was very, our president at the time, George Bush, was very big on the death penalty coming from Texas. And so I was thinking about those things and able to express it. But, you know, again, it's a fashion photography, so there's only so far I can go. The next two pictures, 40, 56, these are an homage. This is Amanda. This is an homage to a painting. And many people have made homages to Liz Taylor, to Andy Warhol. But I thought just to take a particular painting that I loved and do an homage to it. And the next one, please. This is the famous Warhol silkscreen that I so fell in love with when I was a kid. And me and Amanda just talked about it one day. And said, let's do a photograph that looks like the painting. And so we spray painted, you know, drips of black hairspray on her face, and, you know, tried to make it look like a silkscreen as much as possible. Okay, so let's now go to the new. Okay, this series was one of the last series I did. In fashion, this is a series called Jesus is My Homeboy. I just took scenes from the Bible and sort of modernized it. I, you know, personally was brought up Catholic, and yeah, a lot of interest in, you know, ideas of religions and theologies and the different teachings, and, you know, it's always been something I've questioned in my mind. These pictures are sort of the ideas of, you know, what would happen, who Jesus' apostles look like today. It was also, I'm very mad at the fundamentalists of any religion, because I feel like they take they take the good out of any religion and sort of pervert it and twist it for their own uses. And I think that the real teachings are real.